This video is rated 18, suitable only for persons of 18 and over. YouTube, LJ Draco here. Yes, as I said, I was doing three 3D videos. I'm recording them all in one night, as to say. So this is my top 15 Disney 3D titles. Now, I have quite a lot of 3D Disney titles. I know there's still some that I'm missing, but there's not many that I'm missing. I think, logically, I'm missing G-Force. I know I'm missing Up. Incredibles 2 and the Cars trilogy and Meet the Robinsons. Okay, I'm missing quite a few, but I've got the majority, I should say, of the Disney 3D titles. This is just a select 15 that I think stand out more than other 3D titles that I own, and I stick by my judgment. So, as I said, each pile of these 3D videos will have like an A or two honourable mentions. This one has one. Honourable mention is going to be the more recent live action Aladdin. Because this was actually quite surprising. I mean, I'd just watched the live action Lion King, and the 3D to that was so flat, so terrible. I felt so let down because I thought, this looked good. Other live-action Disney films look good. Why Lion King had to look so flat, I don't get it. But this is not one of the best that's in this pile. But it still stood out to me quite a bit, so that's why it's an honourable mention. So, yet again, no specific order apart from I've put my favourites kind of towards the front. I'd say that my top five, one, two, three, four... Actually, no, I'd say my top six are at the front, and then the others are kind of behind. So, the original Beauty and the Beast probably is the best Disney animated 3D film to exist. I have not seen a Disney animated 3D film with better 3D than this. Lion King, the original, does not have better 3D. Little Mermaid does not have better 3D. This is the definitive Disney animated 3D film, and it always will be. But then, talking of modern live actions that are pretty good, the live action Beauty and the Beast, which has just like the live action equivalent 3D. Okay, it's not full frame like its counterpart, this is Letterboxd. However, you do tend to forget about that. Because the 3D in this is so amazing, it captivates you no matter what it looks like. Then, Moana, my most favourite modern... my most favourite modern 3D film. Just because it's... Well, modern 3D Disney film, I should say. I'm not feeling all too well. I started feeling a bit weird during these videos, but I'm going to get them recorded anyway, because why the fuck not? Moana 3D is just... It's a great movie. It's not your typical Disney princess shit. It's not about love and romance and kissing and sleeping and... this is a story about, like, a girl's self... adventure. She just wants to find where she belongs. She doesn't feel right where she is. She doesn't feel like she's her. And to do this in this, like, it's just one of those fantastic stories. And the 3D for this adds so much to it. Tangled, which was my second favorite modern Disney film. 3D wise, it's better than my new second favourite. 3D wise, it's better, but story wise, I did really enjoy the next one coming up. But the 3D for this is fantastic, 50-50, stunning, and it's a great movie as well, I still recommend it. Next up is Frozen 2. This has better 3D than the first film, better story, more enjoyable, so my second favourite modern Disney film. Maleficent, Mistress of Evil. Now, the first Maleficent has very, very unworthy 3D. Now, what I mean by unworthy in this case is that the film is so good and had so many scenes that was worthy of the 3D use, but felt very, very, very let down. Like, 3D was okay and reasonable, but nowhere near as amazing as the 3D on this. This has such an improvement on the 3D that I thoroughly enjoy it. And actually, the same goes for this. I mean, Alice Through the Looking Glass. Alice in Wonderland was an incredible film and had reasonably good 3D. The 3D and the story completely overtook the first in this. The characters, I mean, I love Sacha Baron Cohen's character in this. He is such a good actor when he wants to take the roles. Like, I say seriously, he wasn't overly serious in this, but it wasn't his overreacted stupidness either. Like, I love the depth to what his character was. And playing a character as important as time, he did it well. And yet again, the 3D and the movie just added so much to that depth. This is actually my favourite 3D Pixar movie. Because this, I did not expect that. And I made this, I've explained this before many times, and I'll explain it again. When this first came out in 3D in the UK, because it's from what I know, it only came out in UK in 3D. I looked on YouTube and there was no videos. No unboxings, no reviews, nothing. And I looked for like a day or two. And I thought, you know what, I'll order it and I'll see if I can get my review done on it. And luckily, I did. And it was it is the first to be on there. I've done research and it was still the first showing of a 3D Ratatouille Blu-ray. There it is. And the 3D for this, straight away, it blew my mind, because the beginning scene was Rennie breaking through a window, and you see the depth behind him, you see him in the middle of the screen, and you see the glass coming out. And I was like, what? And I liked a lot of the conversion. Let me just fix my mic, because my mic fell down. I'm not editing this shit out because it's funny. I liked the conversion, and I liked some of the Pixar 3Ds. However, the 3D to this is so much better. And I think Pixar-wise, this has to be the best 3D release. It has to be. I haven't seen a Pixar film that's used better 3D so far. Oz the Great and Powerful. This is an amazing prequel to Wizard of Oz. And the 3D use in this is so outstanding. So, so outstanding. It's ridiculous. Out of the two 3D releases for this franchise, this is actually the best, and I'll always say it. Pirates of the Caribbean, Salazar's Revenge, or Dead Men Tell No Tales, which is the title I prefer. Yeah, the 3D to this is so much better than the 3D for Stranger Tides. I hardly noticed the 3D in Stranger Tides. On this, however, so noticeable, it is crazy. Everything about it is eye-catching, from droplets of rain to the oceans to the under-ocean scenes to anything. Fantastic. I'll actually save that one till last, because that's probably... I'm going to have to say that out of all of these 3D films, this probably has the best use of 3D, and that's... yeah. So, a 3D film that surprised me, because I hated the film, but I watched the 3D. I loved the 3D, and I ended up loving the film, and it is Chicken Little. Incredible 3D for a film that I thought I was going to hate. Monsters, Inc. This is the second best Pixar 3D film. I genuinely have to admit, like, I've got quite a few Pixar 3D films. But I've got Coco and Brave and... Finding Nemo, because Finding Nemo and Finding Dory both have incredible 3D, but this beat both of those by a milestone. Just overall fantastic, like the scene with all the doors, you know, when they're walking around Monstropolis. It's really, really enjoyable. Okay, next up is actually Good Dinosaur, which, yet again, blew my mind. Didn't expect this to be as good as it was, and the 3D actually scared the crap out of me, because there's some scenes in this that's not for kids. Right? There is some scenes in this that are not for kids. Live action Dumbo. Now, this sleeve does look a little bit different. It is a custom sleeve made by my friend Sasha. Only reason why this has a custom is because this was bought and it didn't have an official sleeve. CEX sold this for like, I think it was like £12 with one of their very fadedly crap 3D, very uncut, well, cut, unproper. I can't speak. I feel really weird. It wasn't cut properly, it was trimmed horribly, really diagonal looking, and it faded. So I said, hey, can you just do me a custom, like, to go with the others? And he did, and he did a good job. But Dumbo 3D, this has, for the more modern 3D films, this has much better 3D, and that's why this is actually on my list instead of, like, Aladdin, which was, what was the word for that now? See, I told you, I don't feel right. Honourable mention. There we go. Honourable mention. Okay, so, last film, and like I said, this, out of all my Disney titles, out of every single Disney film I own, and I own at least over 30 Disney titles, this has to have the best 3D presentation out of all of them. And this is James Cameron's Ghosts of the Abyss, which is an underwater documentary of the Titanic. And this has better 3D than Titanic. This has better 3D than Avatar. This has better 3D than Terminator. This is absolutely incredible. This, because I own a lot of like underwater water typed 3D film stuff like Aquaman, even scenes in Sharkboy and Lava Girl, Life, you know, all these three. None of those films, including Titanic, have 3D even close to this. That is my, like, professional opinion. The 3D to this is... I'd say this is along the same lines as House of Wax. This has such closely great 3D, you forget it's a film. You forget it's like a documentary type thing, and you feel like you're on the ship with him. You're going under the water, and you're just exploring the ocean, looking at the wreckage of the Titanic. And James Cameron's known for doing this type of work, because I've heard he's got other 3D titles that's just like this. I haven't seen those. They might be better, but out of everything that I've seen in 3D, this is one of the best. And that's why it's on this list, so... Ghost of the Abyss. That is it for the second video. I've got one more video to do, which is my Marvel films. I really hope you guys are enjoying these videos. I just felt really let down recently because of me doing lack of 3D content. And like I said, I have got a whole shelf, like 90% filled of 3D films. And a lot of these are still good 3D titles. But these three piles are just films that stand out to me, that are personally... better 3D to me. You know, if you've got different opinions, that's fine. You know, let me know what they are. Do you like most of these movies? Do you not like most of these movies? Do you disagree or agree with most of my choices? Always welcome to a standard discussion. Anyway, that is the end of this video. I hope you wonderful, wonderful people take care, you stay safe, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye!